cyber security. You know, before we use the, you know, we enter into the cyberspace, we must know what are the ethics, what is ethical, what is non-ethical in the cyberspace, correct? So, the objectives of this chapter is describe what the term information system ethics means, explain what a code of ethics is and describe the advantages and disadvantages, define the term intellectual property and explain the protection provided by copyright, patent and trademark, and describe the challenge that information technology brings to individual privacy. So, first is the computer and internet crime. We start with the code that in view of all the deadly computer viruses that have been spreading lately, weekend update, would like to remind you, when you link up to another computer, you are linking up to every computer that that computer has ever linked up to. This is a complex sentence. It means that when you are going to connect or link to any one computer, actually you are getting connected with all the computer that particular computer is connected with. That means network, that particular computer's network to which you are going to be connected. Okay. Next is we start with this, that the world's most valuable resource is no longer oil but data. So it means that it's not gold or oil. The most valuable commodity today is information, and we have to understand in the cyberspace we are always sharing our information and our credentials to many people. So they are basically the most valuable commodity nowadays, and most of the users on the cyberspace are not aware of that, or they are not careful about their information, whether they are going to be leaked or it is going to be stolen by some attacker or it is going to be used for some unethical purpose. Okay. So on the internet, information can be created, it can be stored, it can be accessed and retrieved the data. So what is privacy? Privacy is a state where an individual can work on his or her information in circulation with the objective of revealing their identity of information only to selected individual. That means, you know, what information I am putting on the internet, it can be anything, it can be my Facebook post also, right? So the privacy will tell you that the identity of the information, most of the time we want to reveal to selected individuals who are our friends or in our group and we blame, right? And privacy also means to say in a state of anonymity. That means privacy is not exactly anonymity, but it is state of anonymity. Anonymity provides you that what you are doing, it is going to be anonymous online. You are spending something, you are purchasing something, nobody else or any third party will not be able to track that who is the person is purchasing this particular item online, okay, or who is the person is doing this post or commenting or giving this review. Okay, all these things are called anonymity, comes under anonymity, and definitely it is somewhat mean of privacy. Now a real case, this is one of the old case and quite popular to discuss, that is Caesar worm. So what is this? Unleashed in April 2004. So it was, came in the picture in April 2004. The Caesar worm hit IT system around the world, hard and fast. So it was very hard attack, and it was spreading very fast. So didn't spread through email, but moved undetected across the internet from computer to computer. So it was not spread through email attachment or any kind of related to email communication, but it was capable to move from computer to computer throughout over the internet. Exploited the weakness of Windows XP and 2000. So you can remember, if you that time I think primary school, you may not have used XP or 2000, Windows 2000. So it was exploiting the weaknesses, security weaknesses of those operating systems. By first week of May 2004, definitely, American Express, the Associated Press, the British Coast Guard, universities and hospital reported that Caesar worm has swamped their system. Okay? Delta Airlines cancelled around 40 flights and delayed many others for this attack. So Microsoft posted a $250,000 reward for for developing a protection and detection against this worm. And by mid-May, authorities apprehended Seb Jeskson, a German teenager who have given the solution. So Jeskson confessed Jeskson was the person who had created that worm. So Jeskson confessed and was convicted after 3 days trial, and he could receive up to 5 years in prison, but because he was tried as a minor and court suspended his 21 month sentence, leaving him with only 30 hours of community service. So you can understand what was the situation. Then just a few months after Jeskson's indictment, the SecurePoint, a German IT security company, hired him as a programmer. Okay. And a lawyer disagreed over punishment in Caesar trial. So definitely he didn't got a punishment. So introduction to ethics. So a quote from Aristotle is, man, when perfected, is the best of the animals, but when separated from the law and justice, he is the worst of all. So human being is such a have such nature that if you remove all the laws and justice from them, they will be worse than any of the animals. So what is ethics? Each society forms a set of rules that establish the boundaries of generally accepted behavior. These rules are often expressed a statement about how people should behave, and they fit together to form the model code by which the society lives. Ethics is the set of beliefs about right and wrong behavior. Ethical behavior conforms to generally accepted social norms, many of which are almost universal. So virtues are habits that incline people to do what is acceptable, and vices are habits that unacceptable behavior. Right? So people virtues and vices help define their value system and the complex scheme of moral values by which they live. So morality and ethics. Principles concerning the distinction between right and wrong or good and bad behavior, right? So moral principle that govern a person's behavior or conducting of an activity, right? So what a person will do, how he will behave, what kind of activity will do, that totally depends on the person's moral value, right? So in general parlance, morality as a personal set of values on what is good and bad, whereas ethics tends to be concerned with an external body denying what is right and what is wrong, right? So when you say it is moral, it depends on the personal viewpoint, right? But when it is ethics, it is something external body, say your society, your organization, okay, it's some external body can enforce it, a set of rules. Then computer ethics. Ethics are set of moral principles that governs an individual or group on what is acceptable behavior while using a computer. Okay. Information system ethics, set of moral principles. It is a set of moral principles, right? The principle of conduct that guide an individual or group. The same thing, same definition coming up into information technology also, you can see here in the cyberspace, right? So new technology creates new issues in the society, creates environments and situation that people have not seen before. Like, there is a big argument with AI-enabled robots or AI-enabled machines, right? There is big ethical argument, whether it is ethical to fight with robot. That means, say your opponent country is fighting with human beings, their soldiers are human beings. Is it ethical to kill their soldiers? You are sending some robot or some drone, right? So these are ethical issues. Then objectives of ethics are justice and equity in the society, freedom, care and compassion, participation of people, sharing, then sustainability and responsibilities. What is the unethical behavior? Digital plagiarism, like I gave you some assignment, you immediately copy it from the internet and submit. That is unethical, okay? Or say somewhere in your company you have to submit a report and say a new project is being adopted by the company and it is submit maybe in any topic and you have been asked to submit a report on this, what kind of features and what kind of design people will provide to the client. So someone can do something like download similar document from the internet and changing the title and a few things and submit it. So that is what is unethical. Breaking copyright and software theft. Breaking copyright is one thing, software theft is another thing. Like there is a song, see, everybody nowadays download from the internet without paying anything, from the different downloading sites. But we all know that these are some intellectual property created by some people, some creative people, and they are supposed to get the credit as well as they are supposed to get the prize for it. Okay, because these things are means of earning. But what most of the people are doing right nowadays, downloading it simply from the internet and playing in mobile phones, cars, and everywhere. So that is what breaking of copyright, or use it in professional man, in professionals, okay, or resale it also. Then software threat. So you will find many people install cracked software, you can say cracked version of software or leaked key of software people use, So all these things are basically unethical behavior. Imposter use of computer, improper use of computer resources, right? So you are in the lab, you got the lab computers, say, you know, somebody is doing something which can, you know, harm the hardware of the computer system, or somebody is uninstalling some required very important software from the computer unnecessarily. So all these are improper use of computer resources. Okay. Then technology and ethics. So Henry Ford's assembly line. So I think all of you have heard about Henry Ford, that, you know, famous Ford, right? So they created advantage in the in that cars could be manufactured more quickly, okay, and devalued human work skill in the production process, okay. Then Volkswagen Diesel deception. They said that sensor in the car for testing and software performing allowed Volkswagen to cheat on emission testing. So that then that is another you know, technology used in unethical manner. Okay. Then code of ethics, documented set of acceptable behavior for professional or social group, right? That is a documented set of behaviors, that what you can do, what you should not do, defined by the group and identifies specific action as appropriate or inappropriate. So some example of codes are, you know, American Marketing Association have their code, then Academy of Management have their code. Okay, so I'm not clicking on the link, it will take you to that page. Okay, next is cyber crime, is another unethical thing like identity theft, click fraud, hacking, copyright infringement. All these things are comes under cyber crime, and they are definitely unethical behavior on the cyberspace. Okay, so five types of cyber criminals are the social engineers, the spear phisher, then the hacker, the rogue employee, the ransom artist. I think many of you know many of these things, you may not know. So start from the beginning. Identity threat. So there are some unethical people in the cyberspace. They are always, you know, in intention of collecting people's identity, and later they will use those identity detail to, you know, hack their account, create fake account, okay, threatening the people, many things, okay, forcing them to do something unlawful, or, you know, for extortion, anything. So what are the identity, you know, identity credentials they are trying to, you know, threat? It includes starting from your name, date of birth, your you know, parents' names, your address, your PAN card number, your Aadhaar card number, and any other thing, what accounts you have in which website, which bank, in which bank you have your account, what is your account number, you know, your check detail, your credit card detail, all these things. Okay, click for. So it happens most of the time. You will find that many of the SMS you receive, WhatsApp message you receive, email also you receive, having some, you know, having some link. And if you go to that link, it will ask you to click on something. Okay. Or another example, you know, many of the people try to download PPT documents and you know, any other material from the internet. Now, when you try to download it, they will ask you click on this button, download button. But you will click on the download button, it will never be, never been going to download it. What happens? Why they are asking you to click? Because when you click on that, they can collect all your browser information, including your IP address and all. Then there can be an ad embedded into it. If you click on that, the attacker can earn money from that. Okay, so many kind of fraud can happen. Okay, then hacking. Hacking means unlawfully, or you know, some illegal user logs into or, you know, takes access or control of your system without taking proper permission from the owner of the system is a hacking. Okay, copyright infringement, I have already told you. Then the social engineer. Social engineers, this topic I will discuss in detail. It is basically, people certainly will find becoming your friend, and they are showing some helping hand or some authority to help you. And in the background, what they are doing actually, they are collecting all your credentials. Okay, it can include all your personal detail. Then the spear phisher are the people who leads you to fake website to collect your personal information. Hackers, I have already told you. The rogue employee is a kind of employees who are knowingly or unknowingly steals data from the company, or they can also give access to some unlawful or some attackers using their own credentials. Okay, so these kind of employees are there. And then the ransom artist, you already know what does it happens. So these kind of in ransom also in the background there is some attacker. The attackers will install some ransom virus on your system. And if say you are working in a company and you are using a company's system, and in your system you have all the business detail and your business plan and everything important data is there. So what they will do, they will install some backdoor to your computer, and they will copy all the data and encrypt it. And when you will try to access your data, you will find that your data is being encrypted, and some message is displaying that if you want to decrypt your data, you send this much amount of money or click on this link to decrypt your data. So basically, in case of ransom, they collect or they ask for money to decrypt your data and give your data back to you. Okay, then ethical rules for computer users. One shall not use computer to harm other people. Okay, so one shall not interfere with others' computer work. One shall not snoop around in others' computers and respect the privacy of others, and just as you expect the same from others. Do not use computer to steal others' information. One shall not use computer to bear false witness. Next, some other things are there, like one shall not copy or use proprietary software for which one have not paid, right? One shall not use others' computer resources without authorization or proper compensation. Okay, do not access less without the permission of the owner, and one shall not appropriate others' intellectual property, and one shall think about the social consequences of the program written of the or of the system designed by someone. Okay, this is very important for engineers. Okay, then one shall always use computer in a way that ensure consideration and respect for one's fellow humans. Do not copy copyrighted software without author's permission. Always respect copyright laws and policies. Use internet ethically. Complain about illegal communication and activities if found, and to internet service provider and local law enforcement authorities. Then users are responsible for safeguarding their user ID and password. They should not write them on paper or anywhere else for remembrance. Users should not intentionally use the computer to retrieve or modify the information of others. which may include password information, etc. Okay. Next, example a specific admonitions, like no one should either or use others, another's computer system, software, or data files without permission. Designing or implementing systems that deliberately or inadvertently demean individuals or group in ethically unacceptable way. Then organizational leaders are responsible for ensuring that the computer system enhance, not degrade the quality of working life should be ensured by the organization leaders. Okay, ethics and the internet. Few things we need to remember where we do something on the internet or any activity we do on the internet, like acceptance means here it is what will be the acceptance issue for the people who are seeing your post or whoever is related to your activity, what you are doing on the internet. Okay, then sensitivity to national and local culture. Okay, so you should not post something which hurt some national and local values. Okay, while using email and chatting, you have to be cautious and be ethical. Then pretending someone else is one of the crime, you can say, and unethical. Then avoid bad language, hide personal information. When you are downloading something, you should follow Creative Commons rules. They give all the copyright mark that which are so you have downloading you have downloaded an image. Whether this image can be modified, do you have permission to modify it? Do you have permission to use it professionally on your website, or do you have only permission to use it for your personal use, like for a desktop background you can use it, or do you have permission to redistribute it? Okay, so all these things you should be concerned when you are downloading anything, like image, video, audio, MP3, anything from the internet, documents. Then supervision, then encourage children to use the internet, okay, and access to internet. That means